Hello students, in this video we will discuss about kingdom fungi. So there are four members of kingdom fungi which are phycomycetes, ascomycetes, basidiomycetes and deuteromycetes. And here is a flowchart of the kingdom fungi. So they are divided on the basis like first is those who can do sexual reproduction and those who cannot do sexual reproduction. So the deuteromites are the one who cannot do sexual reproduction and hence they are known as imperfect fungi. And those who can do sexual reproduction, and there are all also two types, they are divided into those who have mycelium aseptate and those who have mycelium septate. So those who have mycelium aseptate in this kingdom, in this class phycomycetes will come. And those who have mycelium septate, then basidiomycetes and ascomycetes will come. And what is the meaning of mycelium aseptate and septate? I will tell you later in this video. So here are the features of the fungi kingdom. First thing is they are heterotrophic. As we know, they are not autotrophic because they lack chlorophyll, so they are heterotrophic in nature, and they are multicellular and they are eukaryotic. Okay, there is an exception. All fungi or fungi are multicellular except yeast. Yeast is unicellular, and their body structure is like thallod like structure, means which do not have something differentiated into root, stem, something. So there is a flat thallus like structure, and they mainly consist of threads, and those threads are known as hyphae, and the network of these hyphae are known as mycelium. And the mode of reproduction is sexual or as well as asexual, and they reproduce asexually by spores which are known as conidia or sporangiospores or zoospores, and they reproduce sexually by using oospores and ascospores and basidiospores. And there are all features, another features, they are like their cell wall is made up of chitin, and their life cycle has two phase, vegetative phase and reproductive phase. So out of some fungi, because they are heterotrophic, so they are, some are saprophyte, some are parasitic in nature, and some are lichens. What are lichens? I will tell you. And here is a diagram in which you can see there is a fungi and there is a wall. Okay, so this is septate fungi, this is septate mycelium, and there is no distinguish between. Here you can see this, there is a wall, but there is no wall between them. This is septate and this is aseptate, in which wall is not present. Okay, so here are some important terms about fungi kingdom. Plasmogamy is a fusion of protoplast, and during sexual reproduction protoplast is fused, and this process is known as plasmogamy. And next is karyogamy, means when their nucleus get fused, this is known as karyogamy. And there is also intermediate state during this, which is known as dikaryosis, in which two nucleus are present in one cell, that is dikaryo. Karyo simply means nucleus. So karyogamy means fusion of nucleus, plasma means protoplast. So gamy that is fusion. So fusion of protoplast, karyo is nucleus, gamy is fusion, so fusion of nucleus. And the conocytic hyphae means multinucleated hyphae, means in the case of the hyphae which contains many nucleus is known as multinucleated hyphae. And some fungi are aseptate, that I told you. Septa means wall, aseptate, a means without wall. So some fungi are without wall. As you can see in this conocytic, there are many nucleus present. Okay, and this is the septate fungi. As you can see, there is a wall. Okay, so a wall is present, so this is septate fungi. Okay, and so first is phycomycete, they are lower fungi, and they are mostly marine, they are found in decaying woods. wood, and their mycelium is absent. As we have seen in the flow chart, their mycelium is absent, and they reproduce asexually through zoospores or aplanospores. And here is a figure of rhizopus. Rhizopus is a bread mold. This is the bread mold, and this is rhizopus, and this is the detailed structure of rhizopus. That is, and these brown color fruiting bodies are sporangia, in which spores are produced, and when they and this sporangia is burst out, the spores reach to a new destination and grow a new fungi or new rhizopus there. And next is ascomycetes. They are also known as sac fungi, and they are mainly multicellular, but yeast is unicellular. Their mode of nutrition is either saprophytic, parasitic, or corphophilous. Corphophilous means they grow on cow dung. Okay, and their mycelium is branched and and septate means their mycelium contains wall. And their mode of reproduction, that is, if they reproduce asexually, then they reproduce through conidiophores. Keep in mind, asexual reproduction always mostly take place through the formation of conidiophores, and the sexual reproduction takes place through ascospores. And the example of this are Aspergillus, Celbicapes, and Neurospora. And these are Aspergillus, and this is Neurospora. Neurospora is known as the pink fungi, and this is the figure or the diagram of Neurospora. Okay, and the next is Basidiomycetes. Basidiomycetes, it is the mushroom family, and this is also known as bracket fungi, puffballs. They grow in soil, tree stump, as you know, where the mushrooms grow. And the mycelium is, yes, branched and septate. They reproduce by vegetative reproduction by the means of fragmentation, and sexual reproduction, sexual organs are absent, but plasmogamy takes place. Okay, and here is a basidiomite, so that is agaricus. Agaricus means mushroom, and pucinia is basidiomites. It is also fungi which causes disease in plants, so it is the diseased plant caused by pucinia. And next is deuteromites, which is known as imperfect fungi because of sexual reproduction is absent in them, and asexual reproduction again through conidia, and mycelium is septate and branched. Don't remember these things, because you just need to remember that flow chart, and half of these things will be remembered easily. And some of them are saprophytic and parasitic. Deuteromites mainly are decomposers. Examples are Alternaria and Trichoderma. This is the leaf affected by Alternaria. Okay, and the next here all the fungi are finished, and here are some beneficial fungi. Mushrooms, as you know, it is edible fungi. Yeast, it is also known as baker's yeast because it is used in baking, like for fluffing in cakes and in many dishes. It provides fluffiness to the dish. And mycorrhiza, this is the diagram of mycorrhiza. Mycorrhiza means a fungal association between the higher roots of higher plants and fungus. Okay, this is the symbiotic association. This and this both are symbiotic association. Lichen is a symbiotic association between algae and fungus, and mycorrhiza is a symbiotic association in higher plants, in the roots of higher plants and fungus. Okay, so the symbiotic association in which both gets benefited, one provides shelter, another provides food. Okay, and the Neurospora, it is used in biochemical and genetic work. And apart from these, there are also fungus which are harmful. First is Pucinia rust, as I show you in earlier slides. Second is Alternaria solanae, which cause early blight of potato. This is the early blight of potato to a leaf. And Polytrichum flectum cause the red rot of sugar cane. This is the red rot of sugar cane, which is caused by fungi. And the last is Trichophyton interdigate, which causes ringworm of wood. And these are some only few diseases which are caused by the fungus. There are many more diseases which are caused by them. So thank you for watching the video. I hope you like this.